preparation.
It was the worst day of your life.
The worst day of my life so far. Natalie's had two children, Robert and Andrea, and they had measles or chicken pox or something. So I met Billy after work, after her work, and we bought some coloring books, and we went down to where Natalie lived in a little, well, it wasn't even an apartment, it was two rooms. Anyway, we were there a few minutes when the phone rang, and Jerry went to the phone, and he came back, and he said, "Your father has fallen, and he's in the hospital. Johnny Perkovich is coming to pick you up." So we didn't get too upset. So we got ready, we went out, and Johnny Perkovich was with Eddie Madison. And he started off, he went through red lights. He didn't stop for anything. And I said to myself, there's more to this than my father falling. So we got to the St. Joseph's, so we rushed in. I can still see Natalie, she was ahead of me. And Ted was there. And she said to Ted, "Where's my father?" And Ted said, "Your father is dead." So Natalie went down cold. Okay. And I just went up against the wall. But that was the worst day of my life.
Well, how did Mary and those people find out about it?
Well, they were having trouble finding everybody. Freddie was in the bank. And one of the girls from the bank, she was working late, one of the girls from the bank was there when Daddy fell. And she ran back to the bank and said to Freddie, "You better get to the hospital." Well, the man across the street had a little taxi stand, a big, big Polish man. And when Daddy fell, he came over and he picked him up, like you pick up a child, and he put him in the back seat of the taxi and went roaring off to the hospital. Freddie, I don't know how Mary got there.
Mary was where?
Well, she worked at the Colson.
She was at the Colson then.
I don't know whether she was still in the office or she went home. But Mother and Ted had been out in the car, and Daddy had gone to the office. And when they drove up to the house, it was in darkness. And Mother said to Ted, "I hope nothing is wrong, because Bill should have been home by now, and there are no lights on." Well, Bill wasn't. Then they got inside, and Eddie Madison phoned, and he said, "We're going out the back door of the hospital. We'll meet you at the end of our street." So Mother went, I guess, went rushing up. Eddie Madison came roaring out of the hospital, and he tripped on something, and he fell. I don't know. There were some funny things. Anyway, Natalie was out cold on the floor. The nuns brought her brandy. The nuns always had brandy. But I didn't need any brandy.
The story had it that he met the policeman who was his friend. And
huh?
The story had it that Bill met the policeman who was his friend. And asked Bill how he was, and he said he never felt better.
Oh, he wasn't a policeman. He was Mac Gaffney, the man that introduced Mother and Daddy.
Oh, yeah.
Where?
And he met him on the street.
And the last person that Daddy spoke to was Mac Gaffney. And Max said, "I'll get my car and drive you." And Dad said, "No, I'm going. I'm fine. I never felt better." And Max turned, and he didn't walk five steps. Then Daddy went down.
Oh.
He didn't know what hit him.
Right.
Did you say it was his first day of pension?
Huh?
Did you say it was the first day he retired?
Had he been retired long?
I